Good day and welcome to the very last Edge ever produced, created, constructed by this magnificent crew.
Probably the best crew to ever work on the Edge. No shade to the past years.
But we're better in every way.
I'm not saying he's wrong, but still, no shade at all.
Only good Christmas Edge ever.
On this sad edition of The Edge, we give some very deep advice to the future of DMA.
We reminisce on the great memories within DMA.
Give some behind the scenes of our creative constructs of The Edge.
The Edge's Trent Savage answers a question on every one of our minds. Maybe.
And much more.
I truly believe I have been better prepared for life more in these 2 years at EdTech than my other 10 years of schooling.
You still act like a child.
That might be true, but I really got a grip here, okay?
Oh yeah, I can see that.
Well then, The Edge's Colin Jones shows us what others plan to do with all they've learned and to further their future.
Here at The Edge, as things wind down to the end of the year, so does their time in high school. Working on this last Edge has made me ask the question that many seniors are asking, and that is, what does the future hold for us?
Well, I plan to be a teacher, a kindergarten teacher.
5 years, I see myself working at a high-performance engine shop.
Owning my own business and running jobs and putting out the best work I can.
The skills students have learned here will translate to life after high school and their future careers.
Oh yeah, I've learned so much from just being here. Yeah, they've made a big impact on how teaching and inspiring me to do it.
So I'm going to be a contractor slash carpenter, but as a carpentry business. This is a electrical plumbing class, so I'll be doing electrical for the restorations, be able to redo the whole room if I need to, add on a new room, stuff like that.
Oh yeah, rebuilding the LSs we did. I built a rebuilt a 350. I'm sure that'll help me with my career.
Although here at The Edge we are sad to leave, I am excited for the future. Congratulations to all the graduating seniors in 2023. For one last time reporting for The Edge, I'm Colin Jones.
EdTech has shaped so many and will continue to do so for many years to come.
Thank you to all of the teachers who take the time and allow us to grow.
What do you plan on doing, Grace?
Dissecting dead people. How about you? Now, we take a look at Kyle Schwartz's very funny blooper reel.
Which is basically just 2 minutes and 54 seconds of Jackson Spencer slander.
All well deserved.
Hey, he's a good friend.
Yeah, but he has absolutely zero riz.
Hello.
Peekaboo.
Ow.
Colin Jones reporting for The Edge.
Take me. He's not supposed to be.
Sin City was a maybe.
Excuse me? Bring a portfolio? Be ready for on-spot interview, you must be.
And we'll be headed to the state competition in Grand Rapids in April.
Medical careers and the careers in ed class get worked together last week to give preschoolers a... Okay.
So it distorts his eyes, though his vision is seeing the opposite of what his vision's looking like that.
Yummo! A dandelion. Must be the last one of the season.
I'm Kyra Riggin.
Oh my god.
It's March with St. Patrick's Day around the corner. Many people are used to seeing shamrock decorations. But in the bodega, they aren't just decorations, they are making a difference.
Reporting for The Edge, I'm Bethany Urbanek.
Tiny! Tiny! Tiny, tiny! My love. Oh my god. Tiny! Oh.
Cool. Is that spectacular?
What?
Do it again.
Mm-hmm. Oh. Mm-hmm.
of The Edge. I'm Jackson Spencer.
And I'm Grace Blyle. Sadly, I'm stuck anchoring with him again.
What?
Destiny still arrives all the same. And now it's here. Or should I say, I am.
You guys love yourself way too much. It's sad.
Okay. Can we go back to Jackson's slander, please? It is not as funny when it's myself.
As sad as it may be, the time has come for us seniors to pass the torch for the first years.
Have they really earned it, though?
Daniel, I still don't think you deserve it.
Ouch.
As our senior year comes to a close and the juniors take over the edge, we decided to be nice and give them some advice, and of course give advice to the new upcoming DMA students.
Some of the learning material and jobs that we do in DMA may be a little bit challenging for some, like directing a broadcast, or for others, staying on task can be a bit challenging.
Come to class prepared to do a lot of work every day. You can't really fall behind in this class, or you're gonna bring the whole team down. There's a lot of teamwork, so make sure, you know, you like your classmates. Even if you don't like them, pretend. I do that a lot. It works, but you have to work with them.
Try your best. Don't give up. Just be persistent. The more persistent you are, the better off you'll be. You might have weaker suits at some points, but you'll be better off in others. It just depends. You'll find your strong suit if you stick with it.
Even though advice for learning new material is very helpful, other advice can just be equally as helpful.
Don't spill anything. Don't make messes. Clean up after yourself. But do your work, though. That's probably the most important part.
Don't argue back with Mrs. Holliday when she tells you to do things, because she's always right.
Never challenge Miss Holliday, and never get on her radar, because once you're on there, she'll never let you go.
Hopefully some of our advice was helpful and they can take something from it. Good luck to the juniors with taking over the edge. Reporting for the last time, I'm Bethany Urbanek.
Good luck to the future edge team.
They'll never be as amazing as us.
What do you even do in this class?
Provide the best support and comedic relief to my peers.
Jackson's funnier.
As we move on to the next chapter of our lives,
whether it's college, trade school, armed services, whatever it might be, it can be scary.
That's why we got some advice from some staff here at EdTech to survive the big A word.
The A word?
Yeah, adulthood. What were you thinking?
Yeah, just Kyra Riggin has the advice.
As the year comes to another close, our beloved teachers here at EdTech share with us some parting words and advice for you students in their senior year.
So I'd like to say good luck to all our seniors. It's hard because I feel we only have students at EdTech a short time. So we see you as juniors and seniors, but really get to know you probably more as seniors, trying to figure out a plan or help with post-secondary. And so it's hard. It feels like it goes by very quickly. So my parting message would be just, be kind to yourself, be kind to others, and enjoy life.
Go out and get yourself a career, work hard, and stay out of trouble, mostly. And the best advice I was ever given when I graduated from high school 15 years ago is to go for the big items in life first. Reliable vehicle, and then a house. And don't blow your money.
So my advice for seniors that will be leaving this year is that life is not a straight line. We set off setting goals and thinking we're gonna go straight towards that goal. And the reality is that we're gonna get bumped all over and there's gonna be hills and valleys and all kinds of unexpected things. But that is how things are supposed to happen, and we'll be better for it in the end.
I think that every student that comes out here to EdTech, when they leave here, I think we do a pretty good job of preparing them for the job. For any job, to be honest with you, we teach a ton of life skills, not only just program specific. So yeah, I think that everybody's gonna be well prepared when they leave here.
We'll miss the teachers here just as much as they'll miss us. Thanks to every one of you who made the year a memorable one. Reporting for The Edge one last time, I'm Kyra Riggin.
My adulthood fears have definitely been brought down to a more reasonable level.
I have no fears.
Butterflies.
What about my future? You didn't have to bring that up. Next, the Edge's Ray Buchanan brings you a little behind the scenes of our show in the making.
Do you think they'll find out our secret?
What secrets?
That this whole set is fake.
You know, I'm mic'd too, right?
Throughout the time we spent together here at EdTech, we've made many memories. Lots of friendships were made, and we've connected more than just classmates, but a family. Sure, at points we've had our differences, but at the end of the day, we'll always remember the time we spent at EdTech. Here, I will touch back on our digital media 2022-2023 year.
Role-wise, I would say probably audio. I was on audio a lot.
I do a lot of teleprompting.
I did stage director.
Role-wise, I was mostly an anchor, and I just helped a lot of people behind the scenes with getting their footage, so I guess videographer.
Writing scripts, doing all the lines for everybody, stuff like that.
Every student in the digital media arts class had a favorite memory to go with the class.
My favorite memory here at EdTech would probably have to be listening to Trent's outrageous stories about Tiny. They were pretty weird, but they were pretty amusing as well. I had an enjoyable time listening to them.
My favorite memory would definitely be when we watched movies with the lights off and I'd make weird noises through them, like the one with the rock. I love that. I love the rock.
My favorite memory here at EdTech is probably from last year when we did Just Dance during Christmas. I loved watching Jackson specifically dance to California Girls.
While we had our quarrels with each other, we had a good time at the end of the day.
Quarrels with? No one.
I gotta say Daniel, though. Even though Grace is a close second, I gotta say Daniel. They work as a unit.
I had a lot of quarrels with Bethany Urbanic the most. She's really, really annoying sometimes. I can't stand her some days.
Christina Weeks.
Why?
Well, you see, some people, they just think they're like up here, but in reality, like, they're not all that. And it's just like, you know what I'm saying? That was a live reenactment.
Only person I could say, and when I say this, I know I'm doomed, but maybe, I need my defenses, give me a second. Maybe Miss Holiday. Now, not that it's not deserved, but she always took out my stuff in the Edge. Every time. She always took my stuff out, you know? Not that it's not deserved. I did put a lot of weird stuff.
What a fun year we've had here at EdTech. I'm gonna really miss you guys. This is Rafe Buchanan signing off for the final time on the Edge. See ya!
Christina, don't hurt me.
Weird.
I don't even remember it.
Deep fake.
Agreed. We aren't the only ones with fond memories of our 2 years here at EdTech.
Our Nathan DeFano went out to see what students in other classes' favorite memories about their time here is.
Here at EdTech, and as you know, you probably have been told this 100 times now, it's nearing the end of the year. We wanted to know what are some favorite things students in other classes will remember.
Probably just going here and hanging out with friends and getting work done.
The friends that you meet and how the teachers help us.
How free we are here, how everyone's like brotherhood, brothers.
My favorite thing about EdTech is the food.
Probably the people in the class, honestly, but building PCs was definitely probably my favorite part.
The things that students will miss the most when they leave vary.
Probably Mr. Cobb. He's a pretty good teacher. He really teaches good.
Probably the friends and all the memories that I made.
Just the memories we have here, right? What else?
The people and just being able to be around all the technology constantly, able to learn all that stuff from it.
Many appreciate the relationships they built with their teachers these last 2 years.
Probably how he treats us. He treats us like we're adults.
How he puts the student first and helps us and do everything he possibly can to make us a better person.
Man, just how good of a person she is and just everything she taught me about life and about school, helped me get through this tough time.
Yeah, she's always there for me. And when I was at my lowest, she brought me back up.
They're both really nice ladies, a little bit nosy and very sensitive to noise, but they're good people.
From the things they learned to the people they met, EdTech has left some things with each one of us.
3D printing stuff. That's fun to just take home stuff you make.
All the friendships that I made, not seeing them every day.
My class, oh, how fun it is, man. How great. What the things we've learned, the things we've been through in this class is just different, man. It's just different. The family we've grown here in this class is like no other. Just, man, it's way different from our actual school. This is like actually family right here. Family, this one right here, family. And just everyone can tell me, everyone's just so comfortable with each other. At first, we're all like timid, shy, but time go by, man, we all got to know each other, and man, we created this bond that's very special.
I got brothers and sisters in there that I'll take bullets for.
The fact that they always keep it entertaining.
I know I will miss EdTech. I had lots of great memories here in my classmates. Last time reporting from the Edge, I'm Nathan DeFano.
This place is the best.
The people here are the best.
Well.
What do you mean? Well.
You have your moments.
What's that supposed to mean?
Now, for the moment I know I've been waiting for.
Ooh, are we finally done?
No. It's time Trent Savage answers the one question on everybody's mind.
Well, if you know him, that is. If you know Trent Savage, then you'll probably understand.
But if you don't, you're probably in for a very, very, very odd ride. The Edge's Trent Savage has the infamous Trent Special.
Reporting for The Edge for the last time, I'm Trent Savage, and here in the class of digital media, there has been a strange rumor going around, my rumor, about him, Tiny. My package has video evidence and real pictures to prove that he is truly real and truly a legend.
Reality. And Trent reality. And so I feel like Tiny lives somewhere in the middle. So he could be real, but I'm unclear.
I don't know, I feel like he's like one of those like urban legends, like Sasquatch or Bigfoot. Kind of like, you got some believers, you got some that said they seen him, you got some that are not non-believers, stuff like that, so. That's why I'd be a little shocked.
Personally, it's been a little bit traumatizing. When we did the Christmas Edge, it was just, I don't know. I still don't fully understand what happened. It's just, I don't know. We couldn't hang the chihuahua on the wall, and it was really hard.
Tiny? I have no idea who that is. Isn't that Trent's imaginary friend?
I guess my interpretation would be whatever Trent is interpreting him as the time. I've seen him as an alien, as a demon, as a cryptid creature, so I don't know. He's certainly a character. As for Trent and Tiny's relationship, it's something. That's for sure. It's something.
Do you believe that Tiny is real?
Yes.
No.
Absolutely not. That's a hard question, but I do.
Does he exist? I'd say yeah. You know, I'm a man of the Lord, gotta believe. Man of the Lord, gotta believe in that big man in the sky, you know.
Big man in the sky, the sun.
Science, baby.
First, ladies and gentlemen, Alex thinks Tiny's God.
Yeah.
The amount of things Trent has talked about and giving it to you lightly here are absolutely vile. He draws pictures that I can't even see here. Like, I can't even comprehend what's going through his mind.
So, I'll come out and say it. I'll be real with you. Tiny, he is real. Yes, there was a time where I thought he was dead. That was a heartbreaking time. But then it turned out he came back to life, and he was here. Because you wanna know why? He resurrected. Resurrected from the grave. He literally is God. Okay, I've said it multiple times. Even Alex himself said it. He even believes Tiny is God. And there's no arguments. I mean, it's 100% fact.
So he is real?
That was the most beautiful thing I've ever seen.
I'm still trying to wrap my head around the fact that he's not a figment of Trent's imagination.
I've always known. Always believed.
As all of you obviously know, we just got back from California.
Yes, all four of us.
Technically five.
What do you mean? Chrissy, you, me, Mrs. Holiday, that's four.
You're forgetting Jackson.
All he did was eat and sleep. Do we really include him?
Okay, he does eat more than any other human being ever to grace this planet, but he's still a very valuable part of our team.
And sleep. If we stood still for 2 seconds, he would pass out.
Okay. The Edge's Jackson Spencer gives us a little look at the National Leadership Conference in Anaheim, California.
On April 26th, the DMA BPA team left for the national competition in Anaheim, California.
At Nationals, competition went really good. For our first round, we actually placed 9th, I think, out of 41 teams. And then for the finals, we placed 4th in the nation. For our competition, the first round, we created a 5-minute news package and presented it to one judge. And we were based solely off of our presentation skills. And then for our second round, we had 4 hours to create a 1-minute news story. And we got the prompt on the spot. Our prompt was about esports, so we had to talk about the highlights of esports in every, yeah.
But competing in BPA wasn't the only thing they did in California. They went to many different locations, such as Long Beach, where the sand was definitely not trashed and had a great Chili's with great service. They also went to Santa Monica and messed around in the water before walking the pier. They watched live performers breakdance and somehow saw a dude from Kids React.
Within the first 5 seconds of landing at LAX, we got on a bus, went to the rental car place, and immediately we're just like chilling outside. Dude, this very familiar looking man gets off the bus, right? And I'm looking at him, and I see his face, and then I see his suitcase, and I was like, that's Casey Neistat. 2 days later, we were at Santa Monica Pier. Christina points out a kid from Teens React, like just out of nowhere, just, oh, I know that guy. And we're all like, who is that? And she was like, no. Funniest dude on Teens React right here. And he's working at Bubba Gump Shrimp Company.
The team went to bed early to be up for Disneyland as soon as the gates opened. Everyone enjoyed the deliciously expensive food, immersed themselves into Galaxy's Edge, and took a trip underwater to see Nemo.
Disney, probably the food and exploring the gift shops. I probably spent way too much money, and the food probably wasn't worth all of it, but it was still good. I still enjoyed like browsing. There was a lot of fun things, but everything's expensive.
For the last day, we explored the stars of Hollywood Boulevard, the hands of the Chinese Theater, and the views of the Griffith Observatory. We took a red-eye flight home and left California behind us. I would have to rate this trip a solid 10 out of 10. Just don't go to Chili's. One last time, reporting for The Edge, I'm Jackson Spencer.
I want to go back.
It's too cold here.
Yeah, I can tell you really tanned up while you were there. Well, that's all for the 2022-2023 year.
Good luck to the first year class, although you will have some big shoes to fill. We have faith, kind of.
Make sure to follow us on our Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, Snapchat, and TikTok at The Edge LC. And one last time, I'm Daniel Guthrie.
And I'm Grace Belisle.
Signing off.